This video is education purpose only. Student friends, today I am going to talk on the molecular orbital theory. Main topic is how MOT is superior than valence bond theory VBT. Main topic is how molecular orbital theory is superior than VBT. Example is formation of oxygen molecule. You know that oxygen molecule O2 is formed by the combination of two oxygen atoms. Oxygen has atomic number 8 and ground state electronic configuration is oxygen 8, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. In 1s orbital, 2 electrons are there. In 2s orbital, again 2 electrons are there. And in 2p orbitals, 4 electrons are there. You know that p orbitals are divided into 3 types. One is px, second is py, and third is pz. In these 3 p orbitals, px, py, and pz, 4 electrons are present. If you draw the molecular orbital energy level diagram for oxygen molecule, here is energy. Then this 1s orbital, it has lower energy as compared to the 2s orbital, and there is a large difference between that 1s and 2s. Therefore, 1s orbital is not considered. Reason is that it is a non-bonding molecular orbital. When these atomic orbitals combine, it forms non-bonding molecular orbital. Therefore, we start from the 2s orbital. Here, 2s orbital contain 2 electrons. This is 2s. Here, atomic orbitals. Each 2s atomic orbital contains 2 electrons, and when these 2 atomic orbitals combine, there is a formation of sigma 2s and sigma star 2s bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital. In bonding molecular orbital, 2 electrons are there. In antibonding molecular orbital, again 2 electrons are there. Then there is a combination of p orbitals, and here p orbital combination forms molecular orbitals. Molecular orbital. Here first is, here is a formation of then atomic orbitals of first oxygen atom combine with atomic orbitals of second oxygen atom, and there is a formation of molecular orbitals of O2 molecule. Here is O2 molecule. In this case, here is a single electron, single electron, single electron, and fourth electron goes to the pairing. Then again, here is a single, single electron, single electron, and fourth electron goes to the pair. Then this orbital is sigma 2px, and it contains out of these 8 electrons, 2 electrons. Then here, this is pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz. This is pi 2py equal to pi 2pz, and this is sigma star 2px orbital. And this is molecular orbital energy level diagram for O2 molecule. That diagram is molecular orbital energy level diagram for O2 molecule. Whatever atomic orbitals are combined, that much molecular orbitals are formed. You know that O2 molecule is formed. O2 molecule is formed by combination of two oxygen atoms, and these are the atomic orbitals. These are atomic orbitals. In first 2s orbital, 2 electrons. Then second oxygen atomic orbital, 2s contain 2 electron. 2p orbital contain 4 electrons. Here 2p orbital contain 4 electrons, and these atomic orbitals combine and corresponding molecular orbitals are formed, known as bonding molecular orbitals and antibonding molecular orbitals. Bonding molecular orbitals, here sigma 2s, here sigma star 2s. Then bonding molecular orbitals sigma 2px, pi 2py equal to pi 2pz, and antibonding molecular orbitals are pi star 2py equal to pi star 2pz and sigma star 2px. These are antibonding molecular orbital. This molecular orbital energy level diagram indicate that here electronic configuration for this is represented in square bracket, that is KK means first cell for every oxygen atom, 1s2 electron. There are two atoms, therefore two cells are represented by capital letters here KK. Then there is here sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2. Then here sigma 2px2, then pi 2py2 equal to pi 2pz2, then pi star 2py1 and pi star 2pz1. This is molecular orbital energy level electron configuration. What is that order? Here non-bonding molecular orbitals 1s2 1s2 are represented by two cells. One is K and second is K, that are the capital K's. Then from ground state, here is sigma 2s2, then sigma star 2s2, then sigma 2px2, then pi 2py2 equal to pi 2pz2, then pi star 2py1 and pi star 2pz1. This is the energy order and electronic configuration for molecular orbital energy level diagram. From that diagram, you can calculate bond order. And you know, bond order is equal to 1/2 into the square bracket number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbitals. Okay, then that is equal to 1/2 into the square bracket. Here 2 electrons, then 2 electrons, 4, and these 4 electrons, that is equal to number of electrons in bonding molecular orbital is equal to 8. Then in antibonding molecular orbital, here two electrons and here two electrons, and these electrons are equal to 4, and here 1/2 into 4 equal to 2. According to the molecular orbital theory, bond order in O2 molecule is 2, means there is double bond between two oxygen atoms, oxygen double bond oxygen. There is double bond between two oxygen atoms in O2 molecule when O2 molecule is formed. Out of that, you know that one bond is sigma bond and second is pi bond. You know, sigma bond is formed due to the linear combination of atomic orbitals, and pi bond is formed by lateral overlapping or perpendicular or 90 degree overlap is there, and pi bonding is formed. And here oxygen double bond oxygen, that double bonding is occur in O2 molecule. Then if you consider the stabilization energy, here stabilization energy is, you know, that calculated by relation number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals multiply by minus beta plus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals multiply by plus beta, and that value indicate that here O2 molecule is a stable molecule because there is oxygen double bond oxygen. If you see the number of unpaired electrons, here pairing is occur, here pairing is occur, here pairing is there, here pairing is here, but two unpaired electrons are present in sigma star 2PY and pi star 2PZ. One electron is there, two unpaired electrons are there, therefore magnetic nature of O2 molecule is paramagnetic. It is paramagnetic in nature, means molecular orbital theory indicate that O2 molecule contain two unpaired electrons, and when unpaired electrons are there, that molecule is paramagnetic in nature. Then there is a double bond between two oxygen atoms, bond order is equal to 2. This is the molecular orbital energy electron configuration KK sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2px2, pi 2py2, pi 2pz2, pi star 2py1, and pi star 2pz1. That is the electronic configuration for O2 molecule. But if you consider the valence bond theory VBT, you know that according to the valence bond theory that was put forth by Pauli's and Slater, that Hitler and London theory was extended by Pauli's and Slater, and according to the Pauli's and Slater theory, atomic orbitals overlap and molecular orbitals are formed. In oxygen atom in valence shell, 4 electrons are there. Suppose this is the first oxygen atom. It contains here 4 electrons. These electrons are shown by what? That cross or cross 1. And suppose second oxygen atom, it contains again 2 electrons, 4 electrons. These 4 electrons are shown by the dot in the valence shell, means outermost orbital. And according to that VBT, when there is overlapping of atomic orbitals, then here 2 electrons from first oxygen atom and 2 electrons from second oxygen atom, 2 lone pair of electrons are there in between the 2 orbitals of oxygen. Therefore, according to the VBT, again there is oxygen double bond oxygen. like MOT. But VBT explained that all electrons are paired in O2 molecule, and that picture indicate here is a pairing of electron, here is a pairing of electron, two pair of electrons are there, and according to the VBT, here O2 molecule is diamagnetic in nature. According to the VBT, O2 molecule is diamagnetic in nature, but according to the molecular orbital theory, MOT, here there is a double bond between O2, means two oxygen in O2 molecule, and it is a paramagnetic. Reason is that two unpaired electrons are present in antibonding molecular orbitals, and actually if you prepare O2 molecule, and there is a measurement of what? Magnetic nature of O2 molecule, that O2 molecule contain unpaired electrons, two unpaired electrons are there, and it is paramagnetic in nature, but according to the VBT, O2 molecule is diamagnetic in nature, therefore MOT is superior as compared to VBT. Actual picture of O2 molecule is explained by molecular orbital theory and not by VBT, and therefore MOT is superior than the VBT, and this is the example for the formation of O2 molecule according to the molecular orbital theory, and that's why MOT is superior as compared to the VBT. Next point is, there are some oxygen ions, and there is a study of that oxygen ion. First oxygen ion is formation of positive ion. First oxygen ion is formation of positive ion. Positive ion is represented as O2 plus. It is O2 plus. How O2 plus is formed? Here you know that there is a loss of one electron. There is, when two oxygen atom combines, there is a formation of O2, but one electron is less in that O2, and if you see the atomic orbitals for O plus, and here atomic orbitals for O, means suppose this one is O plus and this is O, and there is a formation of O2 plus. Then again 1s2, 2s2, 2p. In one there is 4 electrons, and here only 3 electrons are there. When 3 electrons are present, one electron is less here. One electron is less. This is molecular orbital energy level diagram for O2 plus. How O2 plus is formed? There is a combination of one oxygen atom and one O plus ion. How O plus is formed? O plus is formed by loss of one electron from oxygen. There is a loss of one electron. Then one oxygen atom combined with O plus, and there is a formation of O2 plus. Then again in the molecular orbital energy level electron configuration, here is a KK, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2px2, pi 2py2 equal to pi 2pz2, pi star 2py1, and here 0 electron. In antibonding molecular orbital, pi star 2pz, 0 electrons are there, because here only in pi star 2py single electron is there, and here there is absence of one electron, because in O plus only 3 electrons are present. If you calculate the bond order, that bond order is equal to number of electrons in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbital. In bonding molecular orbital, 8 electrons are there, 2, 4, and these 4 equal to 8. In antibonding molecular orbital, here 2 and 1 means only 3 electrons are present in antibonding molecular orbital. Here is equal to 5 and bond order is equal to 2.5 in O2 plus ion. Oxygen positive ion, bond order is equal to 2.5. Means this order is increases. There is one unpaired electron, therefore O2 plus is paramagnetic in nature. O2 plus is paramagnetic in nature, and this is the bond order. Then you also calculate the stabilization energy, magnetic nature of various ions of oxygen, and first oxygen ion is O2 plus. Second oxygen ion is O2 minus. It is called as superoxide. It is called as superoxide. How superoxide is formed? You know that O2 plus is formed by loss of one electron and O2 minus is formed by gain of one electron. O2 plus is formed by loss of one electron and O2 minus is formed by the gain of electron. It is called as superoxide. In superoxide, here suppose O minus is there, total 5 electrons are there. When if you consider these 5 electrons in antibonding molecular orbitals, one electron is more as compared to the O2 molecule. Therefore, here 8 minus, there is a 5, and here is a 3, and equal to 1.5. Means there is a decrease in bond order. There is decrease in bond order, but one unpaired electron is present there. It is again paramagnetic in nature. O2 minus superoxide is paramagnetic in nature. And if you see that diagram, here electron configuration, here pi star 2PY2 and pi star 2PZ1, this type of electronic arrangement is occur in molecular orbital energy level diagram of O2 minus. Then third, oxygen ion is O2 double minus. It is called as peroxide. It is called as peroxide. You know that hydrogen peroxide is H2O2. Hydrogen peroxide is H2O2. When there is a removal of 2 hydrogen, there is a formation of O2 double minus. How actually O2 double minus is formed? There is a gain of 2 electrons. We remember that O2 plus is formed by loss of one electron. O2 minus is formed by gain of one electron, and O2 double minus is formed by the what? Gain of 2 electrons. And if you see that here total again, here 5 electrons and 5 electrons, here suppose O and O double minus or O minus combine, and all electrons are pair at that time. Peroxide is what? Diamagnetic in nature, because all electrons are pair. And if you consider the bond order, here 6 electrons, here 2, and that value is equal to 1. Bond order is equal to 1. Means in O2 plus, bond order is equal to 2.5. and magnetic nature is paramagnetic. In O2 minus superoxide, that order is decreased as compared to the O2, and that is 1.5. It is again paramagnetic in nature, whereas in O2 double minus means peroxide, there is a gain of 2 electrons, all electrons are paired, and it is diamagnetic in nature, and bond order is equal to 1. In short, in O2 molecule, there is oxygen double bond oxygen, bond order is equal to 2. In O2 plus, that bond order is 2.5. In O2 minus superoxide, bond order is equal to 1.5. And in peroxide, O2 double minus, bond order is equal to 1. Here first O2, then O2 plus and O2 minus, all these molecules and ions are paramagnetic in nature. Reason is that they contain unpaired electron, but in O2 double minus peroxide there is a gain of 2 electrons. When there is increase in 2 electrons, number of electrons present in bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals are equal. All electrons are paired and therefore it is diamagnetic in nature, and these are the examples of various ions of oxygen molecule. This is O2 plus, this is O2 minus, and this is O2 double minus. That O2 plus is called as a positive oxide, O2 minus is called as a superoxide, and O2 double minus is known as a peroxide. Positive ion, superoxide, and peroxide, and these are the examples of oxygen. And here molecular orbital is superior than VBT. According to the VBT, there is oxygen double bond oxygen, but all electrons are paired. It is a diamagnetic nature, but actually O2 molecule is paramagnetic in nature, and two unpaired electrons are present in O2 molecule. And actually if you measure by Guy balance the magnetic moment of O2 molecule, you know that O2 molecule is paramagnetic in nature, and number of electrons unpaired is equal to 2, and that is the superiority of O2 molecule as compared to the VBT. Our next point is formation of second example is fluorine molecule, F2 molecule. Formation of fluorine molecule, F2 molecule. You know that fluorine has atomic number 9 and ground state electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. When two fluorine atom combines, there is a formation of F2 molecule. In F2 molecule, here in s orbital 2 electrons are there, in 2s orbital 2 electrons are there, and in 2p orbital 5 electrons are there. Like oxygen molecule, here 2s orbital combined with second 2s orbital of fluorine atom, here fluorine atom, and here is the formation of F2 molecule. That middle are molecular orbitals, here left side are atomic orbitals, and these are atomic orbitals, and here total 5 electrons are there in 2p, and here again 5 electrons are there in 2p. Then here 2 electrons forms 4 electrons, 2 in bonding molecular orbitals, 2 antibonding. There here sigma 2px contain 2 electron, pi 2py contain 2 electron, here 2 electrons, and here total is equal to here 6 and here 2, single electron is present there in this molecular orbital energy level diagram. You know that total 5 electrons are present in 2p. 5 means here total is equal to 6, then 4 electrons are there, that remains as it is. Here is 8, then total is equal to 10. Then bond order is equal to what? Number of electrons present here equal to here sigma 2px, 6 electrons, here 8 electrons, and here 6, means total is equal to here 8 minus 6, here 2, and equal to 1. That indicate in F2 molecule there is fluorine fluorine single bond because bond order is equal to 1. You know bond order means number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital minus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbital. Bonding 8 electrons are there in antibonding. Here 6 electrons are there. 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1. Bond order is equal to 1. There is a fluorine single bond fluorine. All electrons are paired. Therefore, this F2 molecule is diamagnetic in nature. And you also calculate stabilization energy by equation. Stabilization energy is equal to number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals multiply by minus beta plus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals multiply by plus beta. Like that you can calculate, and this is molecular orbital energy level diagram for F2 molecule. And in F2 molecule there is a fluorine single bond fluorine. It is diamagnetic in nature. And that's all for the molecular orbital energy level diagram for second period elements up to the fluorine, that is O2 molecule formation. Various O2 ions, positive, negative means superoxide, peroxide formation, and formation of F2 molecule according to the molecular orbital theory. Thanks.